Howdy. What's up, everybody? Well, I'm back from PAX, back from GDC. It's been a crazy, awesome time. Oh, so inspiring. Got to see so many people play Songbringer in person. Tons of great feedback. Got to meet with a lot of great people and share the game. Man, it was exciting being at PAX. There's so many great games there. But anyways, I'm back in the groove here, working on game dev, and today I'm working on the final boss. So I'll play it a little bit just to make sure all the settings are good, the sound and all that. So that was the effect of him gaining. That's when he goes into phase two. So that's what I'm working on today. I'm gonna add a third phase. So I love how like he gets bigger. All his lightning comes across the screen. Does all his light and there's like a good sound effect going for it. I just want to duplicate that basically and do it again. So he's got three different phases. And he starts off small. He goes to be medium size, and then he goes really big at the very end. So each time it sort of like adds to the intensity of the boss fight, and it also brings the music to silence, which kind of like helps you sort of reset as a player. You're ready to go into like the third phase or whatever. So it kind of breaks up this boss fight because this is supposed to be a really long boss fight. It's the last boss fight. You're like, bam, gotta kill him, gotta do it. And it can become very difficult. So the thing is, you kind of want to like have these little breaks. What's up, Benoa? How is everything? Okay, so I'm gonna start by going to Metatron's behavior tree, and I'm gonna add in a second phase switch. What's up, Farpoke? Yeah, I'm good. I'm really good. It was a really busy last couple weeks. What's up, Kukurigu? Howdy, everybody. Okay. Oh, there's grow. So here's where it chooses if he's going to grow. Oh yeah, you multiple deadlines. Oh, that's all right. All right, so we got these two. Yeah, same thing. Everybody's been busy as hell. Yeah, GDC was a freaking whirlwind. Man, I got to see and learn and play and do so much at GDC. And then PAX East was crazy. There's like 100,000 people there. Or like that was the attendance. 100,000. Each day held like up to 35,000 people in this Boston Convention Center. And man, PAX was cool. So many huge games there, like Mass Effect, all Nintendo's new games, the new Final Fantasy. Dude, there's just so many huge booths. Twitch had this huge giant stage there. Yeah, so much. And then there's like all these indie booths too. There's the indie mega booth. That was really neat. What a cool experience to be at PAX and to just, it was very humbling too, to just like be a part of something that's a lot bigger. You know, there's like so many great games at those events. Makes me feel humble. Anyway, so we're gonna take he's got two sequences where he grows, so he can select. This sequence. Or another sequence. All right, so he's got two switches. When he gets to half health, he goes into phase two. And then when he gets down to a quarter health, he goes into phase three. Okay, so here's where it tests again. We'll do the same kind of thing, like select a sequence. It'll look a lot like that. All right, so we select if the hit points are less than a half. Oh, wait, no, this needs to go first. This data format is Valtry. Okay, so yeah, if hit points are less than a quarter, then set scale 1, and if hit points are less than a half, then set scale to 3/4. Yeah, all right. And up here, this quarter health needs to come first. Okay, so there. Now we should have two phases for growing. Let's see if it works. All right, I'll play it. Cool, that was a good transition. All right, so let's see if this next phase works. Oh, don't die. Yes, there we go. Third phase. Let's see if this works. Nice. Yeah, he's all supersized now. It worked. Sweet. That was cool. I like how he's got three phases. Maybe some of his attacks should only be in some of the phases, though. Kind of distinctify the phases. Look how much slowdown there is. It's turning out to be a good boss fight. Alright. That was great. I guess you should check that in. Cool, so basically you just got three phases. Okay. So maybe, there's one more thing I want to do. It's really important. During those, when he gets bigger there in the middle, I want some of the tiles to fall away. So that's next. Huh, how am I gonna do this? What's up, the real Greggy? How's it going? So, I want the boss. Yeah, what's that? What you want advice about? I want him to make the tiles fall away, but only once. Oh, maybe I can create a ground tile. Like, afterward. Oh, okay, I know what I'll do. All right. So this is kind of what it'll look like. When he actually grows, and he's done growing, maybe right here, actually, we'll do special. Something like ground destroy. like 10 blocks. It'll look something like that. Your game's crowdfunding's going live. I hear you, man. I was nervous as hell when I did it too. Yeah, tips on reaching your goal? Of course. Let me give you some. I wrote an article about this. I'll just send you a link to it. There's all my advice about crowdfunding right there for you. Okay, so ground destroy. Right, so we need to write some kind of special thing that goes into the area, finds the blocks that are going to fall away, and then just causes them to fall away. Like deletes the entity that's already there. Okay, this ain't too hard. Yeah, sure. Yeah, special ground destroy 10. That'll work. Okay, so in AI system, we need to hook up this special. All right, and we're gonna do ground destroy. The amount. Oh, nice. Amount. Okay, I think this is going to be, wait, if it's special is the first word. Ground destroy is the first value. So this is float val 1. So dang, we got to open up Xcode so I can debug this and make sure I did this right. I love being able to not even need Xcode open to develop for a Mac. It's great. You can just develop straight from Vim for the most part. Okay, and I'll set a breakpoint here just to make sure that's right. Float val 1. All right, so if the int amount is, oh, this is going to be L around F actually. And this is where we want to go. Like find the existing ground tiles, delete them. There, let's just pseudocode this. Find existing ground tiles. Delete existing ground tiles, create sky tiles, no, ground tiles that fall away. All right, no worries, man. Okay, so let's start with the easy part. See if we can just get the tiles to fall away. Which, let's check an area's header. Because, create ground tile. Yeah, it does do fall. Is this a private method? I think this might be a private. Holy slow down, Batman. Okay, that is public. Good lord. Ah! Man, I can't wait to ride Songbringer 2. Just so I can kind of like reorganize some code. Alright, create ground tile. I think that'll work actually. Let's try it. XY, do fall is secret. That's all we need to know. Let's see if we can just create some ground tiles. Let's do a for loop. This code probably won't actually live here eventually, but I'm just putting it here first because I don't know what I want to do with it yet. All right. Let's just start with like X. I think X 5. And Y 5 plus I. And we get the current area. Area, create ground tile. All right, int x, y. Do fall true. Secret false. Well, whoops, this is a mount. Like to use a variable name n usually for that. Okay, are we using this yet? Ground destroyer? Yeah. Ground destroyer 10. This should happen. Cool. Here's where it's engaging. Nice. All right. Did I get the right float valve? Yes. Float valve 1 is 10. We should get an N of 10. Sweet. It should go and create a bunch of ground tiles that fall away. Let's see if that works. No? Don't think anything happened. Huh. Well, okay, we don't need the breakpoint or Xcode anymore. Nice, man. Page not found. All right, create ground tile. Nice, man. Okay. Don't think that worked, but let's check it again. Oh, does it create ground tile? Check if there's a ground tile. Did he go straight to big that time? Anyways, the tiles did not fall, that's for sure. It's checking the blocks rand Z. Oh, see, it does check if it's sky. Okay. So we need to make sure this becomes a tile sky. And yeah, that should work, I guess. Let's see. Block set. Area. X, Y, sky. Guess I might need to create a sky tile now. All right. Oh, there they are. They did appear. Awesome. All right. Okay, so they needed to be at X4. It looked like a good run of Y. And we need to delete the existing ground tile, whatever's already there. So that means we need to find the existing ground tile. I think they are. Yeah, they're entities. Okay, cool. So, but all they have is a render component. Huh. Okay, so I could give it a name component. Necessarily want everything having an every ground entity have a name component though. Oh, I got a great idea. Oh, okay, cool. So, if this is a boss fight, then the ground, and it's a specific one of the specific tiles that we want it to fall away, then it will actually just do a name component. So basically, yeah, it can easily be found that way. Oh, that's a great. I love this. All right. Okay, so we're going to mark tiles, mark ground tiles that will fall away. Okay, so we have the boss flag and this is the tower and it's outdoors. Whoops. Okay, here's where we're gonna put on the name components. If it's if X is 4 and Y is greater than or equal to 5 and Y is less than or equal to 10. Add okay, so we're going to call all these Metatron ground falls. Now, when so we'll do another value. So for ground destroy, we want to do the name is going to be stirVal1, and then the value is going to be floatVal2. So yeah, we do. So instead of this special ground destroy 10, it's going to be we specify the name. So Metatron. Groundfall. Okay, so in AI system, we just need to make sure that we have these entities. So we're using name components find all and ids name. Don't even need the parent. So we would definitely want to see that. So I got to open Xcode again. Oh, it's the same place. All right, so set a breakpoint there. Okay, so we need to actually get the position now. So int x is going to be, we need to get the position of whatever this, wherever this id is. So we got to get it from its render component. Hold on, I wrote this function for position component. Oh, you gotta pass a get position and render though. So we'll get the sprite's position divided by kid pixel. Actually, just get the sprite's position. Nice. So x is going to be get block x of p dot x. Y should be get block y of p dot y. Okay. Hopefully all this works. I got a breakpoint just to make sure it does. This work. Let's see. So we need to get all the eids. Okay, so the name, what was that? Sturval 1? Yep. Cool. Name, Metatron, ground file, fall. We're going to delete 10 of them. So let's see how many we find. Six. All right, cool. All right, so render. If this worked or not. I guess we'll see if P has a position. Ninety-one, 21, alright. That might be right. XY. 410. Oh yeah, 410. This should be right. Make it a sky tile and create a ground tile there. Oh, we need to delete the existing entity as well. So, and destroy now? No, not quite now. Not quite now. What else do we have for options here? Okay, so we want to tick schedule before tick. This id. So we need the id. All right, let's see if that all works. So when he does this animation, he's about to like get bigger. The sky five, well, actually all six of those tiles should fall away. So they should be deleted. Their image should be gone. Their name component should be gone. But then it should immediately recreate another entity right there. will take its place and fall away, so it appears as if it fell away. Nice. Okay, did it actually... Oh, it didn't create any... I can still walk here. So it needs to create a sky entity there. Okay, so we need to also create a ground tile, but also create a sky... Well... Yeah. Also create a sky tile. Okay, let's try that again. Oh, we should randomize this list once we get it. Cool, it worked. Oh, there's still some blood in the sky though. Damn. That's cool. Okay, so we need some more tiles to go with this. And at most, that should be 5. Okay, and this ground destroy thing needs to randomize the eids. Salad! Ahoy, Salad! Yeah, new overlay, man. How are you doing? PAX was crazy cool, man. It was so great. Man, I mean, 2 out of the 3 days, there were lines, or like lines of people waiting to play Songbringer. I was so humbled. I'm like, wow, look at this. So many people became aware of Songbringer and what it is, and they actually got to play the demo. So many people found the secret dungeon in the demo. I'm like, you guys found the secret dungeon. Like, people were finding secrets everywhere. Seriously, I was so excited when people found the secrets. I'm like, yes, because I knew when people were getting close, so I was always like, find the secret on the screen, find the secret on the screen. And like, several people found it. It was really cool. What's up, Clone Geek? Yeah. I got great reception. Yeah. Lots of people were really happy. And, you know, the press got the chance to play the game at GDC and at PAX. So the press is even starting to say things about it. And I'm really excited to see what people have to say. Like, it's cool. It's getting a really positive feedback. So I'm excited. I'm really excited to get it all finished up over the next couple months and then have it all ready for this summer to release it. So I'm freaking stoked. Finally, you know, this is a long project. This is like 2.5 years already, almost 2.5 years into making it. So it's like cool to see your creation like really start to be shared with people and like, and it be ready for it to be shared with people too. That's a really important part, right? Like if I had tried to share this with people a year ago, it might have got some good reception, right? But like today it's a lot more polished of a game than it was a year ago. So it's cool to do that at the right time because it makes it less stressful for you as a developer to like know that your product or whatever you're making, your game, your creation is ready to be played. Yeah, totally. Yeah, exactly. It's like it's all coming to fruition for sure. Yeah. Yeah, and I gotta dress like a wizard like many of the days. It was great. How about yourself, Salad? What's up? What's new, man? What you been doing? Did you get done with your, was it your midterm you had or the end of term? So there, just randomizing these eids. And then we need to add some more. Go to area. Need more of those. Midterm. Oh, yeah, right. It went well. Good to hear. Oh, I know, right? It's so fast how that happens in a university. It's faster paced. I went to university for a whole year. I'm by no means an expert in universities. Oh, wait, what am I doing? All right, okay, so X is 4. So this is should actually be W2 minus 6. You guys have 8 week study, 1 week exams. Oh yeah, it's similar. Yeah. Yeah. Like sometimes 8, sometimes 10, sometimes 12. Okay, so now we should have 2 sections and it should randomly choose all the tiles. Nice, yeah, cool. It did a couple random tiles. Cool, let's do a few more on the top edge too. Whoa. All right. Nice. Thanks, man. Yeah, I've been working on this guy the past couple days, so just getting back into the groove. I was off for a whole week doing packs, so like coming back is like, dang, I gotta get back in the groove, man. You know how it takes a second to get your creativity like flowing towards something? Okay, so one more line on the top. If y x is greater than or equal to like w2 plus 6, yeah. Right? How's your engine? X is less than w2 plus, oh, whoops. This is minus. Okay, and then it's just y equals h2 plus 1. I think it might just be h2 plus 1. I love guessing. I wish my game loaded a little faster so I could guess even faster. Oh, Xcode's still open. Let's close that. Xcode, you make things slow. Oh, what? Three of these tiles fell, or five of them, they all fell from up here. Can't see. Oh, so it needs to go one more up, and then also it can't go. Yeah, close Xcode. See ya. All right. That was H2 plus 2. And this should be like W2 minus maybe 3. Let's do 3. So there's less tiles on the top. That's not gonna happen again. You figured out the best way to get text. Ooh. Huh. Free type. Right. Cool. Free type's pretty good, right? Because you could, man, you could do whatever you want. You can make anything. If a free type could be a pixel font or it could be a regular font. In a way, free type's kind of like a good choice because you can always take your free type font and render it to a pixel anyways. It doesn't have to be slow performance at all. Let's try that again. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Howdy, bro. How you doing? Right? Huh. Oh, nice. Yeah. Oh, right. for debug info. It's a good point, right? Okay, what was the last thing I wanted to change there? Economy. Yeah, totally. Root packs, GDC, thanks to my awesome publisher, Double 11 for doing that. Like, there's no way I could have had a booth on my own at something like that. You know, you gotta go to the bathroom and take a break sometime. Yeah, I was dressed as a wizard. All the packs. It was great because if I like met anybody, I'll be like, yeah, just look for me. I'm dressed as a wizard. And there's only a couple people dressed as wizards there. There was a lot of great cosplays, I'll tell you that. I saw a sweet Bane. A really awesome Darth Vader. And some of the new Power Rangers. And like so many other amazing cosplays. It was pretty cool. Yeah, exactly. It was a really good idea for like for connecting with people, because people like immediately realize that you're having fun when you're dressed as a wizard. And it's really easy to have more fun when you're dressed as a wizard. So like it just made the whole event just so easy. It's very disarming to talk to a wizard in person, I imagine. Oh, you stuttered. All right. Well, that's all right. Good for you for getting in front of those people and saying it anyways. Oh, I just want these to go sooner. So let's make that fall sooner. All right, so he does the ground destroy there. Let's do the ground destroy right when he's doing this bit. Okay, let's try that again. Yeah, so what I'm doing on today's stream is I'm making the final boss here, Metatron, have three phases. Each one of these phases, he gets bigger. And it's kind of a little epic moment when he... Yeah, that was good. That was good timing, because the whole screen shakes anyways about that time. You could probably do six of these. Maybe three on each side. Nice, right on, Rocket Bunny. That's cool, man. Okay, so, oh, I want more of these Metatron tiles to be able to fall away. Or Y is greater than or equal to like A2 plus 3, and not as sky, which means it's a ground tile, and we'll double check it's a ground tile. Blocks is so there. So now some of the top like bits of the room, they sort of look like horns or peninsulas, should fall away too. If this looks cool, then I can up the number of tiles that fall away, and it'll sort of be like more epic each time. So each time he grows, more tiles like fall away. This is meant to make you feel sort of a little more panicked because, like, there's less room to fight. Yeah, there we go. Some of them fell away up there. Cool. Yeah, that's good. So, really, you should do a lot more each time when it's done. Four oh four not found. Or an iPad Pro, right on. Okay, so now we just need to make more of them fall away. So let's make this 10. Maybe more, actually. Let's do 12. Okay, let's see that happen. Yeah. So I'm gonna hit him again and make sure more of this falls away. Good. That's cool. I like how I think it can go actually more of them falling each time, actually. Maybe let's try four more. Yeah, I'll fix that. I'll make sure to fix that part. We need to recreate the name places. There's a few other things like I also want it, so if the player were standing on one of those places that fell away, I'll need to handle that somehow. I'm thinking what I'll do is make it so the tile just doesn't fall until the player steps off of it. Which I already have the mechanism for in the collision system. But then, yeah, also it needs to recreate its named places. So, oh, actually, you know what? It would be nice. It would be nice if the, the tiles on the side didn't all fall away. It's a good point. It'd make it easier. I wouldn't have to recreate the name places if I just did it that way. It's a good thought. Yeah, all right. So when it's creating those name places here, let's just make sure it's not going to use one of those named place positions. Sky Edge. So Y mod 2 has got to be equal to 1. All right, so I think I can just take that and add it into. And then those two. And you should be able to keep the tile. So I put some yellow dots where they're gonna be able to appear there too. So you can see. Oh, it's still removing a few of those up there. Wow. That's crazy. I gotta check this article out. Yeah, I've heard that before. I've only watched Steven Universe like once. She's the one, yeah, I think I know which one she is. Yeah, they sure have in the last few years. Okay, so it should not ever make this tile fall away. Make sure that the tile, it never makes a tile fall away if you're too close to it. It's gonna have random choices on where it can choose, like which tile. So you always just make it so, okay, I'm never gonna make a tile fall away if it's too close to the player. Yes, this is sweet. All right, and let's go to phase three. Oh wait, it's still not quite the right. So it allowed that one to fall away, but it shouldn't have. We need some more of these guys to come out. Come on, spawn some more. There we go, there's one. Oh yeah, so his arm is a little higher, so it needs to be Y mod 1 equals 0. And I don't really need to see those points anymore. There we go. And I think the Y Can be greater than or equal to 4 there at the bottom. Maybe even 3. Oh, okay, and so the last little bit will be to make it so it doesn't make any tiles fall away that are too close to heroes. Or actually, they're touching heroes, really. We're Gothian, what's up? Did I forget to add game dev to the title? I thought I had that in there. Oh yeah, I got game dev right here. Game dev and programming. Is it really they changed it again? Oh, they did? Oh, wow, thanks for letting me know, guys. So wait, how do I do it now? Oh, it's community based. So I go to, oh, there's a community thing. Oh, great. Oh, good. I'm glad the tags... Well, is it good? I'm kind of glad the tags are gone because I think they're not as efficient of a system if you just got a community. So I go to game dev. Is it game development? Yeah, I guess game development. Oh, there's also an indie dev community. It's indie developers. There's also indie game developers. I'm just going to do game development for now. Seems like more of a... Okay, and so I can delete these tags. Nice. I'll update that for later. So next time I'll remember. Oh, and it's actually bad? They've hidden your followers in browsing communities? What do you mean? How did they hide followers? What's that? Oh. Game dev? So it's not, is it not game development then? Oh, there's game dash dev. Cause wait, I did game dev. And it didn't pop up except for game dash dev. There's only game development or game dash dev. Oh, they don't have the preview thing. Oh, your currently online followers don't show up anymore when you're browsing. Oh, okay. So yeah, game development. That's what I thought. This one has 140. There's 17 streams and 140 people watching. I guess that's what that meant there right now. Well, okay, at least I'm updated for the way the current system is supposed to work. Thanks for letting me know, you guys. They change things all the time on you. Usually they put like some kind of notice, like something pops up here somewhere on Twitch that says, hey, we got a new feature, but they didn't say anything about that. Oh, so the last thing I need to do is make it so it doesn't make you fall, or the tile doesn't fall away. If You're too close to a hero. Okay, so we'll do a vector of V3Is, for these are hero positions for each hero. Hero pause dot push back a new V3I with get block X hero dot position dot pause dot X. Hope I got enough parentheses there. No more water. I gotta get some more water. I'll be right back. Okay, so we've got hero positions. Okay, so if absolute value of x minus, oh, we're gonna loop over for each position in hero, pause, x minus p dot x is less than or equal to one, and y minus, wow, we could have just done Manhattan distance. Is that x? Yeah, xy. Whoops. So if it's too close, then continue the, oh, can't just. Oh, we are using the variable p? Oh, we are. Yeah, so if the Manhattan distance is less than 1, or equal to 1, then we continue the loop and don't destroy this tile, which we should keep on... Oh, I should not be less than n. The count should be less than n, so... Count 0. Count plus plus. Count is less than n. Count's unsigned. Okay, so did all that just to make it so it doesn't make tiles fall away that are too close to the player. So if I stand over here and I do it, it shouldn't do any. This should never make tiles fall away right here. And it didn't. Okay, that was good. Well, let's check it again. Need to make sure that actually worked. So I should set a breakpoint right there. Just to make sure it hits that. And we'll test the X, Y, and all that and see what. Actually, we should just set a breakpoint here too. Good, okay. Now it's getting some positions that are definitely too close to the player. This position is X4, Y5. Right, that should be about where the player is. P of it was 90, 61. The player was at 4, 5 and 4, 9. Is that about right? Yeah, 4, 5, 4, 9. Yeah, cool. And so that position 4, 5 was too close. Should get another one then. Yeah, here we go. Here's another one. It's again 4 or 5. Cool. I think that's working. So the last thing to do is to take this whole chunk of code and make this a function somewhere else. Should probably be a part of area. Written AI system. could totally be an anim though. Alright, let's do an anim. So we're destroying ground. We need to know the name component and the amount of ground tiles to destroy. The tower in the background? Are you talking about the background of my desktop or the tower in the background? You mean in the game? What are you talking about? Oh, give me one sec. It's compiling. Okay, so all this code's gonna belong there, ground destroy. Alright, so you're asking about the tower in the background with the pink glowing bit on top. Is it a shader? What are you talking about, these lamps up here? These things that get destroyed? Pink glowing bit are you talking about? I think that's just a sprite right here. You talking about this? It's just a sprite, there's no shader. I mean, there's lots of shaders making all this happen, so I'm not sure whether... It's kind of... Yes, the whole screen has a shader on it, basically. The whole screen has several shaders. Let's see, name is Thurval1. And amount was L round F float Val2. What shaders? What shaders? There's lots of shaders it uses. There's a lighting shader, there's a blur shader. There's a shadow shader, there's a reflection shader, there's an overall shader, there's a bloom shader. There's a lot of shaders that Songbringer uses. They're all custom. What do you want to, what kind of effect are you going for? All right, so we already got name, already got the amount. Should work. Ground destroy. Now it's in a nice function. Yay! Hooray for functions that do things. Oh, n should be unsigned. You want it to look less flashy. You mean like less like Flash? I don't know. What do you find typical of Flash art? What is specifically that you're trying to avoid looking like? You want flat colors. Oh, that's easy, man. Just draw your stuff with flat colors. But if you want to actually make a shader for making flat colors, that's pretty easy. You basically just need to take the hue saturation. You need to basically get the saturation of a pixel and then make the saturation less and then apply that new pixel back in your shader, in a fragment shader. Oh, you don't want flat colors. Oh, the opposite. Well, then that's the same thing. You just would add saturation to have less flat colors. They can. Yeah, you can take flat. You can find all the colors, all the pixels with flat colors, and just change them to be brighter, more vibrant, less flat, more saturated. Yep, so you're just basically looking at for the HSV calculation off of a single color. Oh, you don't mean flat colors? Oh. Why isn't this running? Oh. Xcode's like. What's wrong with you, Xcode? Oh, it's not even open. That's what's wrong. Do I need to check this again? Probably not. Let's close Xcode. I love it. This definitely adds to the feeling of intensity for this boss fight here. Oh, I guess I could do another whole. More fall, like it could fall out from the outside and then fall from the inside too. All I would have to do is name those differently. Let's see his third phase. Nice. More fell from the top there. Yeah, so more tiles can fall each time. And then the second time, you can make some fall from the outside and then some fall from the inner layer too. That's gonna be sweet. Yeah, basically this is the process, right? You just kind of like, yeah, you want to like identify first what it is that you want it to look like, right? And then identify what techniques will allow you to achieve that look, right? So maybe bloom is the look that you want, or maybe, a saturation shader is what you want, or there's so many like little techniques you can use to get to achieve a certain look. And so once you've identified what you want it to look like and the techniques you need to use to get that, then you just use write those custom techniques somehow. Write your shaders for that, or maybe find those shaders. It depends on your engine. Yay for T. Okay, so I'm gonna check in what I got so far. This is so awesome. These tiles are falling away. Special ground destroy Metatron ground fall 16. So that other one will become Groundfall 2. We'll do like 16 more on the inner layer. This is sweet. We got it in a nice contained function in enums. And here's where we're marking tiles that are going to fall away. What's up, Diamond Killer? Did I miss a B? Oh, let me check. I'll fix that right now. Songbringer. Right? That's always a way. That's always a possibility too. I need a B. Can I get a B? Can I get a B? It's gonna be a part of that layer. Songringer. Oh, we've made so many, like, if there were ever a Songbringer spoof game, it would be the easiest thing to name. You just put whatever funny word you want followed by bringer, and it'll totally work. Let's make this double the size. Songbringer. Nice one, Salad. Yes. Hopefully plenty, right? Right, Dongbringer. Thongbringer. There's a million of them. That looks pretty good. What is this? Five. Five. Yes. Whoops. Merge these layers. Merge them. Merge them. Merge them faster. Kongbringer. Except everybody's gorillas. Yes, Easter eggs, features. Look at all these feature mis mistake features. Bongbringer, oh, that's the best one. Has that, I know, that's, has that been thought before? This is a first. I'm just gonna make this font a little nicer, anyways. Right now, just because I'm in that kind of mood. Best friend. Alright, it's still not that great, but oh well, it's close enough. Good enough for now. Alright, so I was checking in some code. Oh, did I already do that? Yay, I was already checked in. Great. So, have I actually fought him all the way? Yeah, I fought him at the beginning of the stream. It was great with all three phases. Oh, this is so great. I can check this off my list now. Yeah. Metatron's second form? Not only does he have a second form, he has a third form. He's got three freaking forms now. And each form is sort of intimidating. You're like, what? He just got bigger. Nice. There's so much left to do with this final boss, the final boss scenes and all this. But yes. Oh, more tiles falling away. That's right. Yeah, Trello is pretty great. I was just keeping my list in a text file for a while, and then everybody's like, you should try Trello. And it's definitely more organized than a freaking text file, I'll tell you that. It's really nice to have them all. You can prioritize them, move them around, put them on different lists, and add pictures, which is really great. You can have people contribute to it. So there's a lot that's awesome about Trello. And I only got 100 things left on my list until the game's done, of the important things that I'm aware of right now, and things I have left to do as far as features like the ending cutscene and all that. Okay, so we wanted to destroy. Yeah, alright, so we'll have a special for each one of these. So if his hit points are less than a quarter, he's also going to destroy some Groundfall 2s, which is good, should be pretty exciting. I know, right? Yeah, one a day, I could totally get that done. And a lot of them are like, I'd say about 50 of them are relatively fast items where, you know, I can definitely get 4 to 8 of them done per day. So, yeah. I should be able to rip through at least 50 of them. Like if I wanted to, I could get them all done in a week, just all 50 of those. And then so it's really only like 50 big things left to do that would potentially take up an entire day. So yeah, there's enough time. It's going to be a good game. It's going to turn out good. I got to keep telling myself that though, because like it's nerve wracking if you don't believe that your game is going to be good, you know, like. That sucks. I know that feeling. You're like, damn, there's not enough time. But in this case, there is enough time. It's all going to be good. All right, so Metatron Ground Fall 2. Where the hell was that? Oh, it's area. I know sometimes you do cross one out and you get 5 new ones, but I'm pretty sure I know I will add some to the list on the way, but I have a feeling those won't be as important as the things that are on the list now. I know that. Thank you, Red Saint. Cheers. Right, yeah. We won't release it too early. Okay, where the hell was that? Metatron Ground Fall, there it is. Okay. So we want a second row. Yeah, let's do a whole another second row. Let's start with the two edges. If x is w2 minus 5, y is greater than 4, da, 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 da. We don't need to worry about this, though. This little edge bit. I don't think we need these two to start with. We just change this to a 5. And then this will be Metaton Groundfall 2. All right, so now we should have two rows of tiles that could fall away. I know, right? How do you make this look less flashy? Oh. Well, oh. Wait, this? It says I have a wrong turn. Who's the we other than you? Yes. Oh, I'm a one-man creative team. I'm talking about my publisher, Double 11. They're the ones putting the game on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One and potentially other platforms. And we have to do this thing called a sim launch. It's a really great technique for launching your game. You should listen up. This is really important. A sim launch is when you launch everything on one platform or all your platforms at once. So, for example, you're launching on Steam, you're launching on Xbox as well at exactly the same time on exactly the same day, right? Same thing with PlayStation. All three of those are launched on exactly the same day. It's a very powerful synergistic effect that you generate marketing-wise for your game because everyone can play it on whatever platform they want. You're going to get people that are going to review it on the platform they prefer and also shared with other people because it's on all those platforms. You've got so much more just synergistic power with your word of mouth, with everything. Everything about your entire launch is just better by sim launching. So when I say we, I mean myself and Double 11, this whole team of like 30, almost 40 employees work for Double 11, and they have their own custom game engine that they use for PlayStation and Xbox. And it's wicked fast. So, anyways. Oh, sorry, I didn't check this image here. How do you make this look less flashy? Don't use vector art. That would be my first thing to say. Just don't write your art as vectors. Make pixel art, for example. That would make it instantly less flashy. The second thing that would make it less flashy is if this art was more... there's a feeling of this art has kind of been like clip-arted out, right? There's like these sort of cartoony things, but that's like there's not a lot of cohesiveness to this art. It's not quite... it's not quite... The background could be a little more backgroundy. The foreground could be more foreground-y, but it's to make it all kind of like cohesively as one unit, you know? It's a really aesthetic thing, you know? So you just got to kind of get your aesthetic right. That's all. It's not that hard. Yeah, the GIFs, you can't get a good GIF at 60 for sure. Well, can you? Additive blending for a fire, that's a good point. Yeah, it's definitely a good suggestion there. How long have I been working with them? Oh, wow. Quite a while. Over a year. But yeah, we just finally announced it. So it was something we just announced last month. So last month was the first time I ever talked about Double 11 because we kind of had to keep things like under wraps at first because you have to like when you start making you start making people aware about your game that's coming up, you really want to follow it through with like lots and lots of great content and lots of updates and, you know, everything. You put a lot of effort into your marketing like 6 months before releasing a game. You know, that's the time when you're really pumping it hard for the marketing. So that's why we just started talking about it now, because the game's coming out in summer. No, you don't have to make it necessarily pixel art, but you know, like you can make it less vector, less cartoony. No, TFK. Microsoft did have this one clause on Xbox that you cannot release your game on Xbox if you've already released your game on another platform. I'm pretty sure that's how the Xbox something clause, I forget what it was called, but the Xbox like blah 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 clause. But anyways, Microsoft's kind of lenient about that. And secondly, we're doing it the right way. We're launching on all platforms at once, so Microsoft's happy with it. Microsoft's only not happy if you're launching, and I may be wrong about all this, so check this all out yourself. You know, this is just from what I understand. Yeah, so we're doing it right as far as that, you know, consoles go. Yeah, right. Yeah, it's good to know, right? So if you want to release your game on multiple platforms, the best way to do it is to do it all at once. But if you can't, I'm pretty sure you can still contact Microsoft and get them to allow your game to come out on another platform if it's already been out on some other platform already. You can still talk to them and they'll a lot of times they'll allow it, even with their clause, from what I understand. Okay, so let's see if this works. We got Groundfall and Groundfall 2. Let's see if the scripting's done too. So let's see if this works. So I'm going to let him do his first intro and then I'll hit him hard and he'll do his first phase switch, and then I'll hit him again hard and he'll do another phase switch, and both those times all these tiles should fall away. Some tiles fell away right from where he's standing. I guess we could make it so tiles don't fall away if they're right underneath him. Yeah, I definitely agree with what Farpoke's saying here. You look at this in just a slightly different light, and I think you'll make what you're trying to do easier. You don't have a particular look? Well, find one then, you know, find one anyways. Find that look, or draw that look, or find, you know, just identify what it is that you want, and it will be way easier to get what you want. Okay, so the ground tiles fell away, but they fell away from underneath the boss, so we need to make sure it's not. Okay, so we're gonna add in all of the bosses on the screen. Actually, all the foes, any current foe. Or auto id in entity get all AI component. And if hasn't, wait. Yeah, hasn't fits e collision dot category k filter actually should be original category. If we don't have, if we do have foe, then push back another not pause basically. So now we should be pushing back anything that's a foe. So it should go through all those not pauses. Yeah, so there, let's try it this time. This time, so no tiles should fall from underneath Metatron. Let's hope. Oh, we should take away some pillars. Pattern, this is inside boss. We want the outside boss. Boss B. There you go. There it is. Outside tower. All right, so there's a mill bit. Why are any? Let's get the X delta. So abs of X minus W2 is less than or equal to 4, it might need to be 2 or 3. Oh, nice. Looks good. Looks really good. I like it. Kind of would be cool if or y mod 2 equals 0. And then the leather did here y mod 2 is not equal to 0. Well, that actually looks pretty good. Going around. Make sure the right tiles fall. Good. Okay, good, 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 good. All the right tiles fell there. And now we kind of got this crazy cat look almost to the whole screen. Okay, I want to make sure that once some more of these ice dragons spawn, that they are actually touching the right tiles. Like it so far. Yeah, cool. He's grabbing onto the right tile over there. Okay. Oh man, 9 p.m. I know that feeling though. I'm on it right now because I got back from Boston this week, so I'm like a weird sleep schedule. Okay, I'm gonna try them square anyways. See what that looks like. That was cool. I do like seeing it like this, I think. One more thing, there should be allow it should allow the tiles in the very top. Y mod 2 is not equal to 0, or Y is greater than or equal to H2 plus H4, or something close to that. Nice, so a whole bunch of the top ones fell on that one. Yeah, I love seeing it be able to get rid of that. But did that actually delete? That might have deleted too much. Yeah, I think it did. I think a dragon is probably going to be able to go up here. Let's see when another dragon spawns. Find out. I'm pretty sure dragons can go all the way up to the top there. got a dragon now. Another dragon, good. All right, you dragons, can you get all the way to the top there? Oh, yep, see? Okay, so that needs to be at least one more. Nah. Oh, was it an old policy? Let me find out. I don't remember exactly. I think it was an Xbox One policy, but let's find out. Xbox. Parity clause. Yeah, there you go. It's called the parity clause, and here's some more info on it. Okay. Did I add one? Oh, it was H2 right here. This needs to be plus one at least. Love that. It's so cool. All the bricks fall away and everything. Ah, this is great. It's exactly what I had in mind for this little boss fight. Let's see these inner ones fall away now. Yes. Yeah, I love it. Oh, wait. Oh, the top ones are still deleted too many. Damn, this is H2 plus... I guess this must be plus two. Yes, it does damage you. Yeah. If a lightning bolt hits you, you would get hurt. Not that much, but yeah. Your brights out. Oh, I know. It's so funny when a company tries to make something seem like it's good for... And, you know... Things are really just best for the company, and they try to make it seem like it's good for everybody here. People are smart. People realize things. Okay, good. These tiles right underneath Metatron should not fall away. Good. That was good. Nothing fell away from underneath his feet. Everything looks good. Yes, this is awesome. Oh, this is what I wanted. He just gets bigger, and all the tiles fall away. This is so cool. Oh, and yeah, and this works. So this tile up here... is still there, so that when the dragon jumps, you can still appear there. Ah. Awesome. This has really come along. This whole boss fight has really turned out. Ah, so satisfyingly good. I like it. This really is fun. It's a long boss fight. It's fun. It's got three phases. Nice, Rocket Bunny. Right. Okay, so I'm checking this in. Metatron and M's area and area patterns. And I think I'm going to be done with my stream after this, after I check this in right now. My legs are tired. I'm not used to standing up so much. Man, I had to stand a lot at PAX. Lots of standing. Rocket Bunny's gone senile. He's 14 and wait, you just turned 15, right? Or was it 14? Okay, so what does all this code do? Makes the tiles fall away, that's right. I should check one more thing actually. One last thing before I go. If I delete all the tiles. Okay, so if we do pump up these numbers a lot more, right? So this is like 26 each. It should be deleting all the tiles. And therefore, we can double check that it doesn't delete tiles from underneath the feet of the player and the enemy. Comments? What are those? And oh, the life of a programmer. Okay, this is the last confirmation that the right tiles fall away and it doesn't delete a tile if, like, you're standing on it. So, I shouldn't kill him when he's in the middle of the screen. I want him to be towards the edge of the screen. Go to the edge of the screen, man. Oh, there. Close. Oh, he jumped to the edge. Well, if I stand here, it should... Yes, good. So the ones that were right here did not get destroyed. Okay, cool. It's good enough. It's good enough. It's good enough. Undo this, these three changes, and this can be committed. Most of you with two do. Oh, you just turned 14? You definitely cannot be going senile. If you were 15, I would think maybe you could be senile. But because you're 14, it's all right. You're definitely not senile. You won't be commenting at all. All right. It's always gibberish. Oh, dang, dang. Okay, so I'm going to look through this check-in, and then that's going to be it. Special ground destroy. Now, when it does the ground destroy, it makes sure not to place it, place or to destroy tiles that are underneath the enemy, any kind of enemy. And then also it adds in some more, another layer of tiles that can fall away. All good, sweet. Metatron fight has two layers of ground tiles that fall. Boom, sweet, yeah. Mission accomplished. This boss is a sweet fight. Well, that's it for today's stream. I'm gonna set my ass down, rest my legs. It was good seeing you guys again after a freaking week of being gone. It's good to chat. What does senile mean? It means you're old and you start forgetting stuff. All right, guys. So, yeah, it was good seeing you. And I'll probably be streaming tomorrow. I'm not sure exactly. Kind of taking it easy now that I'm just easing myself back in the flow of game development. So, anyways, it was really good seeing y'all. And I appreciate all y'all. And we'll see y'all again. What does it mean? I forget.